To raise the debt ceiling and give Texas $15 billion to recover. Can the president move his agenda forward with the current GOP leadership, or does he have to move without them? Joining us right now is a man I know the president respects, House Freedom Caucus member Jim Jordan. Congressman, the president was frustrated. He acted that way. He is not upset that he did it. He actually feels, I think, emboldened because of it. Are you okay with the move?
Well, no, I don't think it's a great plan for taxpayers. Anytime Nancy Pelosi likes something, it's probably not the best deal for the American taxpayer. But let's be clear here, Brian. He didn't have many choices. You know, I learned a long time ago, lack of preparation typically leads to poor results. When you don't prepare, you're left with poor choices, poor options. The president had to do something. So the biggest problem was we didn't stay here in August and put together a debt ceiling plan, one that actually addressed the underlying $20 trillion debt burden that we face as a country. So to me, that was, we took the longest August recess break in a non-election year, the longest break we've taken in over a decade. That's why the House Freedom Caucus called for 9 weeks ago, back in July, we said, stay in August, let's figure out the debt ceiling, let's put together a tax reform plan, and let's figure out how we're going to repeal Obamacare. And instead, we went home for almost 6 weeks, longest break in over a decade in a non-election year.
Right. Crazy. Even though you guys passed a lot of bills, a lot didn't get done.
The important stuff didn't get done. You can pass all the bills you want, but what do the American people want us to do? Build a border security wall, cut their taxes, and repeal Obamacare, and not keep adding to the debt without actually addressing the problem. So we haven't got the key things done. That's what the American people care about.
You know, Steve Bannon said the establishment does not want, Republican establishment does not want to see President Trump's agenda or President Trump be successful. Bring us inside the Beltway. Is he right?
I think there are a lot of folks in this town who aren't on board with what the American people elected Donald Trump as president to do and a Republican Congress to do. And we've got to overcome that. And it starts by actually making some decisions, taking the time to prepare and put together good public policy, and then go have the debate. Then go have the debate with the American people. If we had an option out there, we think you should cap spending, take the debt ceiling, for example, raise the debt ceiling, but cap spending as a percentage of GDP going forward. Don't let government ever grow and grow and grow. Put together a plan, go sell that to the American people, and then you got something to offer the president versus just what Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer offered him 2 days ago.
Right. Do you want leadership to change? Are you okay with Speaker Ryan?
I want us to do what we told the American people we were going to do. Again, I've said this on your show, Brian. I've said it on so many shows. We make the job way too complicated. What did the American people elect us to do? Let's do that in spite of what the establishment in this town may want to do. Right. In spite of the obstacles we face, let's do what the American people elected us to do. That's what I want to focus on, and we had better do it pretty quickly.
Right.
And it starts, I think, next.